नमस्ते बिटिया, माई सेल्फ जेवियन नेहा सैनी फ्रॉम फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक्स, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। हेयर आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट द एनाटॉमी ऑफ द सर्वाइकल वर्टिब्री। सो इन द वर्टिब्रल कॉलम वी हैव सेवन सर्वाइकल वर्टिब्री, 12 थोरासिक, 5 लंबर एंड 5 सेक्रल प्लस 1 कॉक्सिजल वर्टिब्री। टुडेज क्लास इज ऑन सर्वाइकल वर्टिब्री। सो इंट्रोडक्शन। Cervical vertebrae, they are identified by the presence of foramina transverse arium. So in the diagram we can see this is the foramina transverse arium through which the vertebral artery is passing. So this is the identifying feature of the cervical vertebrae. There are total 7 cervical vertebrae. 3 to 6 are typical, 1st, 2nd and 7th are atypical cervical vertebrae. First, we study the structure of typical cervical vertebrae. Typical cervical vertebrae contains body, as it is demarcated in the diagram, vertebral foramen, vertebral arch. The other features are the foramen transverse arium, the costo transverse bar, then the anterior tubercle, posterior tubercle, superior articular facet, lamina, spine, which is bifid, means it is divided into two slips. So this is the bifid spine. Then the vertebral canal is triangular in shape. So these are the identifying features of a typical cervical vertebrae. Now the body is small, broader, and it is concave superior surface with upward projecting lip. So the lips of the superior surface of the body, they are projecting upwards like this. These are the lips of the superior surface of the body. Here we can see it is projecting upwards, and the anterior surface is beveled. Beveled means sloping downwards. So this is the anterior surface of the body. So in the image we can see the anterior surface of the body is sloping downwards. So this is the identifying feature of a typical cervical vertebrae. Then the inferior surface is saddle shaped. Inferior surface is this surface. It is saddle shaped. Anterior border is projecting downwards and hide the intervertebral disc. Intervertebral foramina, that is superior and inferior. So here we can see the intervertebral foramina. This is the superior and this is the inferior. Superior vertebral notch is shallow while deep, while the inferior vertebral notch is deeper. So in this way we can identify the superior and the inferior surfaces and the notches. Then the vertebral foramen in the diagram, it is the green colored highlighted area. It is larger than the body and it is triangular in shape. Then the vertebral arch. Vertebral arch contains the pedicles. They are directed backwards and laterally. Superior and inferior notches, which are of equal size. Laminae are relatively long and narrow, thinner above than below. So then the inferior and the superior articular processes, they form articular pillars, project laterally at the junction of pedicle and the laminae. Then the transverse process. Transverse process, it is pierced by the foramen transverse arium, as it is shown in the diagram. Each transverse process has two roots, that is the ends. These are anterior tubercle and the posterior tubercle. It is highlighted in the diagram, anterior tubercle, and this is the posterior tubercle. And these are joined by the costo transverse bar. So this is the costo transverse bar. Costal element is equal to the tubercles plus the costo transverse bar. So the costal element of the developing cervical vertebrae is represented by the tubercles, that is the anterior tubercle and the posterior tubercle, and the costo transverse bars in between them. The site for articulation with the rib is these costo transverse bars and the tubercles. The anterior tubercle of 6 cervical vertebrae is large and it is known as carotid tubercle, because at this point the pulsations of the common carotid artery can be felt. That is why the anterior tubercle of the 6 cervical vertebrae is known as carotid tubercle. Then the spine, it is short and the bifid. So the spinous process It is small and it is bifid. As we can see in the diagram, this is the bifid spine. Notch is filled by the ligamentum nuchae, and the space between these two processes, it is filled by the ligamentum nuchae or nuchal ligament. It gives origin to deep muscles of the back of the neck. Now the attachments and the relations. The anterior and posterior longitudinal ligaments are attached to the upper and the lower borders of the body. As we can see in the diagram, this is the anterior longitudinal ligament on the anterior surface of the body, and this is the posterior longitudinal ligament on the posterior surface of the body. Then the upper borders and the lower parts of the anterior surfaces of the lamina, they provide attachment to the ligamentum flava. So on the lamina we have the attachment of ligamentum flava. Here we can see in the diagram the location of the ligamentum flava. This is the ligamentum flava on the lamina. Then foramen transverse arium. Why we have foramen transverse arium? This is for the passage of vertebral artery, vertebral veins and branch of inferior cervical ganglion. So this foramen transverse arium, which is the identifying feature, it is providing passage for these structures, and it is important you should remember what are the structures which are passing through foramen transverse arium. Then the anterior tubercle gives attachment to scalenus anterior, longus capitis and oblique part of longus coli. These muscles are highlighted in this diagram. This is the longus coli. Then the scalenus anterior is on the anterior aspect of the neck. This is scalenus medius. This is scalenus anterior. So these are the muscles of the neck which are arising from the anterior tubercles of the foramen, anterior tubercles of the typical cervical vertebrae. Now the posterior tubercle gives attachment to the muscles of the posterior part of the neck, like scalenus medius, scalenus posterior, levator scapulae, splenius cervicis, longissimus cervicis and iliocostalis cervicis. So these muscles are highlighted in this image. Then the costal transverse bar, anterior primary rami of the corresponding cervical nerve passes through the superior aspect of the costal transverse bar, as it is shown in the diagram also, the schematic diagram which is showing that, for example, if there is cervical 6 vertebrae, then the costal transverse bar passes the anterior primary rami of cervical 6 vertebrae on its superior surface. It is also shown in the diagram also. This is the anterior primary ramus. Now the ossification. It ossifies from 3 primary centers and 6 secondary centers. The 3 primary centers, they appear at the time of 8th week of intrauterine life. And the 6 secondary centers, one for each vertebral arch, arises at the age of 7th or 8th cervical week of the intrauterine life. Now we come to typical cervical vertebrae. So these are the summary of a typical cervical vertebrae, the identifying features of a typical cervical vertebrae. All the highlights are numbered over here. For example, number 1 is body, which is having the intervertebral disc. Then we have the transverse process. The transverse process is divided into 2 tubercles, anterior and the posterior tubercle. Then between them, there is a costal transverse bar. Then there is foramen transverse arium number 5 for the vertebral vessels and vessels. And there is superior articular facet. All these structures are highlighted in this image. So, next we come to the atypical cervical vertebrae. Atypical cervical vertebrae is cervical 1st, cervical 2nd and 7th cervical vertebrae. First we come to the 1st cervical vertebrae. It is known as atlas. See the location of the atlas vertebrae. It is just beneath the skull. This red color is the atlas vertebrae, 1st cervical vertebrae. The identifying feature of this is it is ring shaped. It has no body and no spine is present. It has anterior arch which is shorter. So this is the anterior arch. It is short. It is a long posterior arch. Then there are lateral masses right in the left. Lateral masses. These are the lateral masses. And there is transverse process having the foramen transverse area. So these are the identifying feature of the first cervical vertebrae, that is the atlas. Then the posterior arch, it is longer than the anterior arch, as we can see in the image also. So this is the identifying feature for anterior and the posterior aspects of the bone, that the posterior arch is longer than the anterior arch. There is median tubercle present on the arches. So the median tubercle and the lateral masses, we have superior articular facet. This superior articular facet is for the articulation with the occipital condyles. Then the joint formed between them is the atlanto-occipital joint. Now the inferior surface has the inferior articular facet. So inferior articular facet are demarcated. These are the inferior articular facet. These are circular, more or less flat, directed downwards and medially and backwards. They articulate with the corresponding axis vertebrae to form atlanto-axial joint. Medial surface has roughened tubercle for the attachment of transverse ligament. So the medial surface of these articular facet is roughened. Here we can see these are roughened for the articulation of the transverse ligament, which is horizontally oriented. It is demarcated with this yellow color line. Now the transverse process projects laterally from the lateral mass, long, acts as lever for rotatory movements of the head and is pierced by foramen transverse area. Now the attachments of the atlas vertebrae. On the anterior tubercle, we have the attachment of anterior longitudinal ligament. As we can see in the diagram, this is the anterior longitudinal ligament. And on each side, we have the longus coli. So on the east side, we have the longus coli muscle. This is the longus coli muscle, we can see in the diagram. Then the upper border of the anterior arch gives attachment to the anterior atlanto-occipital membrane. So here we can see the anterior atlanto-occipital membrane. This is the anterior atlanto-occipital membrane on the anterior arch. And on the posterior tubercle, we have the attachment of this ligamentum nuci. This is also clearly visible. Then the groove on the upper surface of the posterior arch, it is occupied by the vertebral artery, as we can see in the diagram, and by the first cervical nerve. So this groove is formed by this vertebral artery pulsations. Then the transverse process gives attachment to rectus capitis lateralis, superior oblique, inferior oblique, levator scapulae, splenius cervices, clinus medius muscles. So these muscles are attached on the transverse process of the atlas vertebrae. Then the ossification, again by the three centers, one for anterior arch. It appears at the age of 7th week and ends at the age of 1st year. And the other two primary centers are for the lateral masses, which appears at the age of 7th week and fuses at the age of 3 years of the life. So these are the highlighting areas of the first cervical vertebrae, that is the atlas. Then we come to the second cervical vertebrae known as axis vertebrae. It is identified by the presence of dense or odontoid process. Odontoid process, it is strong tooth-like process projecting upwards from the body. So here we can see this is the dense. Again we can see the dense of the axis cervical vertebrae. This is the dense identifying feature. Superior surface of the body fused with the dense. Dense articulates anteriorly with the anterior arch of the atlas and posteriorly with the transverse ligament of the atlas. So recently we have studied the transverse ligament of the atlas, which is articulating with this axis vertebra. Then inferior surface is prominent anterior margin which projects downwards. Now the axis vertebral arch, it has the pedicle The superior articular facet, the circular, directed upwards and laterally. Inferior surface, it is deep, wide, and inferior vertebral notch. Lamina, they are superior vertebral notch behind the superior articular process, and it is thick and strong. It has transverse process, having foramen transverse arium, and the spine is thick, large, very strong, grooved inferiorly and bifid. So here we can see the attachments and the articulations of the atlas. This atlas articulates with the first cervical vertebrae, that is the atlas, and forms atlanto-axial joint. So this is the facet for median atlanto-axial ligament. The anterior surface of the body gives attachment to longus soli and anterior longitudinal ligament, while the posterior surface of the body gives attachment to posterior longitudinal ligament and the cruciate ligament, membrana textoria. The tip of the transverse process gives attachment to levator scapulae and scalenus medius, and the spine gives attachment to the ligamentum nuchae and the vertebral muscles. So here we can see the identifying features and the most prominent points of the axis cervical vertebrae, and the attachments also, they are demarcated with the numbers. Now the 7 cervical vertebrae, it is again a atypical vertebrae having spinous process which is not bifid, and it is very large and project posteriorly. It is also known as vertebra prominence. 7 cervical vertebrae or the vertebrae prominence, it is identifying by its following features, that is, it is long, thick, horizontal spinous process, it is not bifid, ends in a tubercle, it has a transverse process which is large, posterior root is larger than the anterior, anterior tubercle is absent, small foramen transverse arium sometimes absent or double. Then the attachments, it includes on the spinous process we have the attachment of ligamentum nuchae, trapezius muscle, rhomboideus minor muscle, serratus posterior superior, splenius carpitis, semispinalis thoracis, all these are muscles, spinalis cervices and multifidus. Then on the transverse process, on the transverse foramina, it provides passage for only accessory vertebral vein. There is no passage for vertebral artery, remember. Posterior tubercle gives attachment to the suprapleural membrane, and then lower border gives attachment to the levator costerum. Then ossification is similar to the typical cervical vertebrae. Separate center for each costal process appears during 6 months of the intrauterine life and fuses with the body and the transverse process during 5th to 6th years of the life. So these are the important landmarks and the attachments of the 7 cervical vertebrae. We just go through it. Now the questions related to this topic are, write short note on first cervical vertebrae. So in this you have to mention about the identifying features, anatomical features and the attachments of the atlas vertebrae. Then the second question is identification points of the typical cervical vertebrae. So in this we have to mention about the identifying features of typical cervical vertebrae, what is the vertebral arch, what is vertebral body, how it is appeared, and also draw one diagram. Now this is for your exercise. You have to draw this diagram. This is the diagram of typical cervical vertebrae and label all the structures which we have studied right now. Then this is another exercise. In this we have to draw and label all the structures of the atypical cervical vertebrae. Use pencil colors only graphite pencil, and there is no other color for the bones. You can use black pen for the outline and for labeling the structures. So this complete the topic, cervical vertebrae. Thank you.